Basing is an important part of collecting any army, and it's always a good idea to keep it consistent across the entire force, because while doing that, really binds all the miniatures together. Now, sometimes it's fun to do something a bit unusual, and in this video I'm going to show you how to create a really cool toxic swamp base. This is great for Nurgle miniatures especially, but, well, you could use it on anything if you wanted to. Now, doing this is actually very easy, and it's lots of fun as well, so let's get started. It's usually best to do the basing on your miniature as the last stage, so I recommend you fully paint your model before you start doing this. But you'll notice as well, on my base, I haven't actually got a miniature. That's because I want you to be able to clearly see what I'm doing. What I have got though is a skull, which I've glued on at a funny angle and painted it as well, and that's because I want this to be bobbing around in a big puddle of toxic goo. Now, once you've got your base ready to start, what you need is your spreading tool, and I'm going to be applying some Stirling mud to this. So make sure you get a good scoop on the shovel end. And, well, all you need to do is start applying this onto your base. Now, I like to put quite a lot of this on so I get a really good texture on it. So you just need to put it down, start spreading it around, and, of course, just be a bit careful as you get into the feet of your miniature. You might want to switch around to the narrow end when you're doing that. Now, when you get into areas that you want to have a puddle, like around the skull, for example, you just need to make sure that you don't apply any texture. The colour doesn't matter. It's all about the texture that's in this paint. So when you get to these areas, just make sure that you keep scraping those bits clear so you've got a flatter area like that. So now what I'm going to do is just carry on painting this all around the base and getting it fully covered, and then I'm going to give it plenty of time to dry. I recommend with this you leave it for at least an hour so it's fully set. It's very important that it's fully set before you start the next stage. I've given the texture paint plenty of time to dry, and you can see on here I've got three areas that I've kept, well, textureless really, for the puddles later on. So I've got this quite large one running around here, then I've got one at the back, and then a small one down here as well. So once this is all ready, the next stage is to apply a dry brush over this. And the colour you need to do this is Tyrant Skull. Now, to do a dry brush, the brush you need is a medium dry brush for this stage. And you just need to get some of the paint loaded on the end of your brush, not very much. And then what you do is get some tissue and just start working that paint into the tissue like this. So you're working the paint amongst all the bristles and also getting rid of the excess paint, because you don't need very much. In fact, you want your brush to be looking, well, kind of like that before you begin. Now what you do is get your base and then just lightly start drawing your brush back and forth over the texture, and you'll see the paint immediately starts catching on all the raised surfaces and really picking them out. So you can see this texture now from a distance with some nice highlights on it. So what you need to do is just work across all your base doing this and all the texture. Don't worry about the areas where all the puddles are going to go, because we'll paint them later. But you will need to be careful of your miniature, so be careful as you work around his feet and also around any details like the skull here. And with that dry brush done, the mud is now finished. So the next thing to paint is going to be, well, the puddles. Now for this, the first colour you need is Caliban Green for a base coat. And I'm going to apply this using my large brush. So you just need to use your palette to get this paint ready. I'm going to add a little bit of water to it, not very much, just to thin the paint down and give me a bit more control over it. So mix that in there and load the brush up. And, well, what I'm looking to do is paint this completely over all these flatter areas where we want to have the puddles. So around here, for example, you just need to start base coating this colour on. Just being careful of anything you've got in amongst the puddles, like the skull here. Now I've finished applying the Caliban Green, you can see clearly where these puddles of goo are going to go. And the next thing to do is to paint on the actual colour of what this goo is going to be. And for this you need Nurgle's Rot. Now I'm going to be applying this in, well, the same way really. I'm not going to thin the paint down this time. I'm just going to use my large brush to get some ready, then just start applying this on. Now Nurgle's Rot is quite a transparent colour, so this is why we did the Caliban Green in the first place, you see. You'll see that through it. So when I start painting this on, well, you can see immediately, you can still see that Caliban Green through there. But what you must do when you're doing this is resist the temptation to apply this colour too thickly. About the thickness I'm doing here is perfect. Let this first coat dry, then apply another one afterwards. If you do it that way, you'll build up a much smoother finish, a much smoother one then, and then if you do one really thick layer. So I've done three coats of Nurgle's Rot, and, well, you can see it's given me this really nice wet shine, which is perfect for this horrible toxic goo, isn't it? And also, if you look around that skull, I've just done a little bit of it lapping up around the edge of that skull there, just to make it look like it's, you know, bobbing around in that big puddle. So with that done, the goo is finished, and there's just a couple of things left to do to finish off the base. And the first of these is to paint the rim of it. Now, what colour you do here is largely a matter of personal taste. Some people like to do black or a dark brown. I like Steel Legion Drab most, because this is a very neutral colour, so it tends to blend in with whatever board you put the miniature on. So I'm just going to be painting this around all the edge of the base now. So I'm still using my large brush, just get the paint ready with a little bit of water mixed in just to smooth it down. And you're just looking to apply this as smoothly as possible all the way around the edge of the base. So around here, I'm just going to be going around. This is going to take about 2 coats to get a solid colour. But as I'm going, I'm just going to be careful not to get this colour onto that texture. With the steel lesion drab done, all the painting on the base is now complete. And if you want to add just a bit more character to your base, then a great thing to use are grass tufts. Now I'm going to do this on mine, and the ones I'm going to use are Mordheim turf. So to do these, you just need some super glue thin. All you've got to do is pick one from the backing film, get some super glue thin. You don't need very much, and all you do is just paint a small amount of this onto the back of the tuft, like that. Then, grab a hold of your base, and just find a spot on it you want to place it down, and just press it down onto the texture, just like that. Now you can add as many of these as you like, but I recommend that you don't go crazy. Once you've done this though, your base is complete. So there you go, that's how you paint a toxic swampy base. And as you can see, it looks great with your troops stomping through it. Now, when you're basing your miniatures, always remember to give the texture paint plenty of time to dry before you start dry brushing over it. And if you're going for this style of base, when you're using the Nurgle's Rot, remember to apply it thinly and build up a couple of layers rather than applying one thick layer. It'll get a much better end result that way. And finally, whatever way you decide to base your army, always keep it consistent across the whole force, because basing is a really good way to unify a whole collection. Now, this video has been lots of fun to do, and I really hope you guys have got something useful out of it. So I'll see you next time.